In part one of our lesson on trigonometric equations, you will learn how to solve by linear methods. In this first example, we have to solve on the interval 0 to 360 degrees, and we're given the equation 2 sine theta plus 3 is equal to 4. A lot of this will feel like an algebra problem. The first step would be to subtract 3 from both sides, so that now we have 2 sine of theta is equal to 1. Next, we would divide both sides by 2, so now we have sine of theta is equal to 1/2. And now you have to do some analysis. Because the sine of theta is positive, that tells us that our angle could be in quadrant 1 or quadrant 2. We use our special angle reference chart to see that theta r is going to be 30 degrees. Now, when we come up to our drawing and put theta r in both of those quadrants, we see that we're going to get 30 degrees here, or we're going to get 150 degrees here, because of course, for that second angle, we had to start at 180 degrees, subtract 30 degrees, and end up at 150. So the solution to this equation then is that theta is equal to 30 degrees or 150 degrees. In this next example, we have to solve it on the interval 0 to 2 pi. So that tells us we will be in radian mode. So first, we can subtract 5 from both sides. Now we have negative 2 tangent of x is equal to 2. Divide both sides by negative 2, and we get that the tangent of x has to equal negative 1. So when the tangent is negative, we know that means our angle has to be in quadrant 2 or quadrant 4. Using the special angle reference chart, we know that theta r is going to equal pi over 4. Now we have to put theta r in the picture here and here. To find the quadrant 2 angle, we know we have to start at pi and subtract pi over 4, so that's going to be 3 pi over 4. To find the quadrant 4 angle, we have to start at 2 pi and subtract pi over 4, and we know that that would be 7 pi over 4. So we get as our solution that x is 3 pi over 4 or 7 pi over 4. In this next example, we'll be solving on the interval 0 to 360 degrees, and we're given 3 cosine theta plus 5 is equal to 3. We'll start off by subtracting 5 from both sides, so now we have 3 cosine of theta is equal to negative 2. We're going to divide both sides by 3 and get cosine of theta is equal to negative 2/3. Now, because the cosine of theta is negative, We know that means we're going to have to be in quadrants 2 and 3. Now, this is not one of our special angle values, so we're going to have to turn to our calculator. And we know that if the cosine of theta is equal to negative 2/3, then theta would be the cosine inverse of negative 2/3. So let's head over to our calculators. First, we want to make sure that our calculator is in degree mode, so we hit the DRG button, and if need be, cursor over under the degree and hit enter, and you will see that it indicates that it's in degrees. Now we will do second cosine inverse, and we'll have to enter negative 2 divided by 3, close the parentheses, hit enter. And we see that we get 131.8 degrees, rounding to the nearest tenth place. Now we have to think about what this means. We know that one of our angles is in quadrant 2, and we know 131.8 degrees is a quadrant 2 angle, so solving cosine inverse of negative 2/3 gave us one of our solutions. It gave us this 131.8 degrees right here. Now, to find this second angle that's in quadrant 2, we need to know what this reference angle is right here. So to find theta r, we can start from 180 degrees and subtract that 131.8 degrees so that we'll then know what the reference angle is. So theta r is going to equal 180 degrees minus 131.8 degrees, and we get 48.2 degrees. And to find that second angle, we know we're going to do 180 plus that 48.2 degrees, and we're going to get 228.2 degrees. So we know then that our solutions are here and here. So theta is equal to 131.8 degrees or 228.2 degrees.